Very nice to have you all here to honor our dear friend, Little Queenie Harris. It's going to be a blast. We've been rehearsing for 2 weeks, and we got a cavalcade of stars up here.
Talk amongst yourselves. Yeah. I've never heard Tipitina this quiet. It's like a library. Yay, you're all here. And you're all vaccinated, goddammit.
Yay.
That may not be the only time I say that, but thanks and stuff. Maybe we'll be okay. Wait, before we get started.
I didn't bring my drink.
To Leigh.
To Leigh.
It's so quiet. Everybody's sober and quiet. Are you sure this is a Leigh Harris show?
It's early.
We'll warm them up. We'll warm them up.
Somebody yell and throw out expletives.
Fucking right.
Sounds a little muffled for some reason.
There we go. That's what I like to hear.
Your mic's okay?
Yeah.
Mic's all good. Okay?
Yeah. All right, Darcy, kill him.
All right. Here she comes with the sand.
Stacy Morjo.
Stacy!
MVP. MVP, yes.
Oh, sorry, Josh.
We read the lyrics because we care.
It's an accident of enthusiasm.
See how this works.
I'll try to contain myself.
Oh, somebody brought a tambourine. Great.
The club brought a tambourine.
Yes.
We've all been trained. We're licensed tambourines.
No way I can play percussion in it. All
right.
All right.
Is it me? Is it you, baby?
Okay.
Come on, y'all. Let me see you move around. Done gone fishing and let my and now they pack it. Gonna skyrocket, getting fatter than the crab. Ow! Oh, New Orleans, my darling. Finale.
Yeah, good night, everybody. That's it.
So at a certain point about 20 years ago, Queenie formed a band called Mixed Knots. And it was basically like a bluegrass ensemble that played Hendrix and Zeppelin and anything she wanted, a lot of New Orleans stuff, a lot of old tunes. So we're kind of going to kind of reenact some of that with this crew. And a lot of these singers sang with that band. So here we go.
Here we go.
Why did I leave?
It's fancy. I like the whole shit.
One, two, three, four.
Thank you.
That's Debbie Davis, y'all. Give it up.
Yeah, you're right.
Ah, go on.
Hey, thanks for really, coming to on. The Leigh-a-palooza.
Wait, as I like to call it. Because we care.
You can spray my face.
It's got rubbing alcohol in it, but sure.
It's just alcohol. It won't hurt you.
If you're afraid of alcohol, you're in the wrong place.
That's right. Just came to the wrong gig, folks.
All right.
It works on so many levels.
Sure, that's coffee in there.
Just the truth. True love will last forever. Thank you.
Oh, yeah, that is me. Okay. Good thing. I know this one.
That's Allison Young, y'all. I'm sorry. I know we're all out of practice. That's Allison Young, y'all. That's what I thought you said.
So this is the aforementioned Little Queenie's affinity for Jimi Hendrix songs, which she wanted to do it kind of hillbilly style. So this is Manic Depression. All right. She liked it in tune as well. So hold your horses.
Who doesn't?
So how you feeling so far?
Tell who anybody is. You all look like you're about to hold up a stagecoach.
Yeah. That's who wins.
Oh, just wait, buddy.
All right, here we go.
Go tell myself and go on down. Yeah, really ain't no use in me hanging around. Your kind of scene. Music's been music. Wish I could caress and kiss. Manic depression's a frustrated mess. Thanks, y'all.
We want to bring up another dear friend of all of us in Lil Queenie, Lenny Zenith.
Yeah. Leigh was a dear friend to all of us, and she really taught me what it was about to fall in love. And also to play music and sing. So this is for you, Leigh.
Thank you.
Okay, Leigh used to call our next guest the man, the guitarist with three brains. This is Mr. Phil DeGree. He's an amazing musician, so please welcome him.
Lord, I'm so tired. How long can this go on?
That I work it in a coal mine, going down, down, down. Working in a coal mine, whoop, about to flip down.
Working
in a coal mine,
going
down, down, down.
Working
in a coal mine, whoop, about to flip down.
'Cause I make a little money, hauling coal by the ton. But when Saturday rolls around,
wear that mask above your nose, take it down when the cocaine flows. That's so last century. I'm Dr. Phil, and I have no patience. Especially with these anti-vaxxers. I don't know where they're getting their bullshit information from, but what, the QAnon, the Facebook, the Twitter? I don't know. She's an anti-vaxxer and may just be. Asymptomatic. Deceivably, she's an anti-vaxxer, doesn't know jack shit. Shit. I can't do this shit, man. You better mask up. You don't want her spit. 'Cause she refuses to be tested and goes out having fun, then snorts a Delta 8 bomb, then pandemonium. Holy shit, how dumb. Now we all have to suffer and succumb. She's an anti-vaxxer. She's way, way out, way, way gone. Believe stupid shit from QAnon. Case closed.
Wait, I gotta do that again. What I get for rehearsing for 1 hour.
Thank you.
Here's a little piece. Quite a becoming title here with these unprecedented times. This is an old tune by the Young Rascals. Leigh and I discussed doing this. We never got around to it, but anyway. We love Leigh forever. And this is called How Can I Be Sure? How did Yoko get in here? Thank you for being here. Thank Leigh for existing, and onward through the bullshit.
Okay, this is the shorter microphone, so I'm going for this.
Oh my God, hello! Woohoo! Oh, wait, oh! Wait, please? Oh, sorry.
Well, you know, we're all trying to emulate
me. Wait, Polly, back up.
Sorry, I appreciate that very much.
See, it's not that hard.
Turns out.
Sanitizing is good. So we're depicting Leigh in different
fresh
outfits. This is Leigh in her normal jazz festival outfit. This is Leigh on a casual afternoon outfit.
I don't know what
and
the
this
hell
is Leigh
is
dressed up.
Triple goddess, what
yeah,
do
the,
you say?
Yeah. I don't think you should have it any other way.
What are we doing?
We're doing Jazz Fest.
Okay.
Jazz right. Fest and Laissez Faire.
And then we're going to do the thing with Allison.
This is a song. Darcy. This is a wonderful song that Holly wrote, actually with MC.
Yeah.
About the Jazz Fest, and it mentions...
Remember the Jazz Fest?
Remember that?
Remember that? We used to have that.
Someday, it'll come back.
Yeah, says
it's
you.
It's coming. But anyway, it mentions all of our favorite, so many of our favorite Jazz Fest performers, and of course, Leigh is among them.
Absolutely. And this was written in the 80s, y'all. This is the first song ever written about the Jazz Festival. I was trying to mention everybody that's in it. And you know, of course, we had to mention Leigh. And when Amosy and I recorded our all-original CD, Leigh came in and sang her lines in that mentioned her herself. So
which is somehow perfect.
Just for her. And for the mini jazz fest, we stood there and sung the backups to Kiss.
All right, Am.
Oh, and this is her ring. This is my homage ring. Sing along when you know the parts. Well, it's been a long winter and money's been tight.
I've been working two jobs, staying home every night.
But now winter is over, I'm through paying dues.
I got to get to New Orleans to get rid of these blues.
Ain't no place in this world I'd rather be in the spring than
down at the jazz fest in New Orleans.
With their grandma and jump in the car.
Well, you know it ain't very far. Get you some sunscreen so your dorm brought too red.
I hung my old college roommate with lonely up there.
But it don't really matter, I ain't going to sleep.
I'm going down to the jazz fest in New Orleans. I let that cayenne pepper burn away my winter time. Working in a coal mine, but
holy cow, I wish my friends back home could see what I'm doing now.
Second lining with Irma,
radiating off steam.
Because I'm down at the jazz fest in New Orleans.
I let you walk into New Orleans.
With fast, I'm a no, just text me.
Who shot the lala?
I'll answer, I know.
The Zack Attack,
the Zack Richard, the Zydeco King.
My darling New Orleans, little Queenie will say.
No place in this world I'd rather be in the spring than down at the jazz fest in New Orleans.
It's called a musical turnaround.
Just let me onto that fairground and get out of my way.
Songs on this. This one is our song, but Amnesty and I wrote, but however, this is Leigh that put the good lyric in it. I had a line in the first line that went, something so attractive in a city, and attractive is a really crappy word to sing, you know? So when Leigh started doing it in her shows, which really was an honor to us, she changed it to seductive, and it's just so much better that way.
Well, and the first time I ever sang this song was with Leigh, because I hadn't joined the Pfister Sisters yet. Leigh is the reason that I joined the Pfister Sisters.
Right.
And she's the one who gave me the tape and said, learn these. I think you're going to have an audition. And the audition turned into a rehearsal, and we had a gig a week later.
And Leigh was like, yeah, I can't. We're not going to sing. But, you know, I got this girl, and she's just about as crazy as y'all.
You got to get that Debbie girl. She'll learn all this stuff in 5 minutes. Yeah. It'll be fine.
And so I learned the song to do it with Leigh, and then I was alarmed to find out that it was actually also in the Pfister Sisters set.
So anyway, this is easy to sing along with. Y'all know this one.
It's about why New Orleans isn't like the rest of the, not only the rest of the country, but the rest of the world. We just ain't.
That's all right, you can clap for that. Remember when we didn't used to feel like everybody else.
But is this yours?
No, this is mine.
Oh, I don't know who's this. I don't know whose this is. I better put it back down.
Because we don't drink out of each other's glasses anymore.
Damn it.
Well,
mostly.
There is something so seductive about a city.
Imagine leaving here for the first time and being kicked out of a bar because it's late.
Or Jesus. Or
and
something.
Then they wouldn't even give you a go cup or anything.
I have to leave and I have to
leave. I was so confused.
Don't worry, y'all, because that's not the way it is here in Big East.
Laissez-faire.
Jesse Miller, y'all. It's like a Zoom meeting, but
Debbie
we can
Davis,
hear you.
Yvette Volker, my fellow fisters. And we're going to bring up some more wonderful singers. We got Miss Darcy Malone. We got Miss Allison.
Hello.
And we got a lovely song written by Mr. Miller here. And it's got a sing-along type chorus to it. If you wish to sing along, it's always going to be... Anyway, the chorus will be, little Lee, take some time and sing for me.
Sing to me,
little Lee. So if the spirit moves you, and I hope it will, please do that.
Sing along. How could this be right? Took your spirit home with me. Then I took delight in all the things I now could see.
Believe me, my friend, there is no final end to all.
Chances were so slight, but who could know what I would see? You just can't dim her light. She's still here for us all to see.
Believe me, my friend, there is no final end to all.
The chorus, y'all.
Little Leigh, take some time and sing to me. Sing to me, little Sing to me.
you, Amnesty, for writing that. I couldn't make it through in rehearsal, but it did okay tonight. I was like,
So thank y'all so much. Thank y'all for coming this evening, too.
Amnesty Miller on the piano, Holly Benson, yeah.
Like many of you out here, I've been coming to Tipitina so long, I had a deja vu when I saw that man at the door. And he said, oh, you remember Joe Cool being at the door? And I go, I remember Stanley being at the door. That's how far back I go.
All right, folks, this is Tom Maron. It's his birthday today. I think he just made like 27 or something like that. This is Paul Clement. It's not his birthday. I'm Jimmy Robinson. We used to play in the Mixed Knots group with Leigh, and this is a song that I wrote for her that we played like 100 times, and it's on her record called Cue Ball. And, we miss us some Leigh. I dreamed I was awake, you were still here, nothing had changed. Dreaming, I'm awake again, everything comes rushing back perfectly clear. You were laughing, but you cried all day, red lines in your eyes gave it away, and in passing, you're having to say it's been a long, slow fall to this goodbye. I really believe that was just that one time, never really mattered at all. That long, hanging moment between the chase and the fall, and the rest of it all was just a long, slow fall to goodbye. Goodbye. Thank you very much. Okay, we have another, a new friend of ours, a fantastic singer that we just met in the last couple of years, and she's going to do a Trent Reznor song that, I don't know that Leigh played this song, but Leigh got hired by Trent Reznor. This is Layla Musselwhite, ladies and gentlemen. Leigh got hired by Trent. If you don't know who Trent was, he's the guy from Nine Inch Nails, to do a bunch of background vocals. And at the beginning of the session, he was very polite. He apologized because the lyrics were going to be kind of obscene. And Leigh just cracked up. If you know Leigh, she was just like, because she had a tendency to write really bawdy lyrics to pop tunes and stuff. So anyway, this is called Hurt.
Day, see if I still feel. Focus on the pain, only thing that's real. Needle tears a hole, old familiar sting. Try to kill it all away. I remember everything.
become my sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end. If I could start again,
thank you, Jimmy. Thank you, Little Queenie.
Leigh Musselwhite. We got the Bonorama horns in the house, ladies and gentlemen. Greg Hicks, Craig Klein, Mark Mullins. And my band, Woodenhead. We got Fran Comiskey on keyboards over here. We got Mark Whitaker on the drums. Paul Clement on the bass. We used to combine our two bands together, and Leigh would come and sing with us, and it was like the roof would blow off the place when she would start. So we're going to do a couple things. Debbie Davis is going to kill this one for us.
Somewhere a king has
traffic lights that turn blue tomorrow.
That's we did. There's a recording of the first Jazz Fest after Katrina, 2016, and Leigh had about 30 people on the stage, including us, three accordions, two piano players, about 50 singers, and we did that song, and we also did this next one that we're about to do for you. And we're going to bring up Lenny Zenith to sing this. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm out of order. I'm sorry. This is going to be Papa Miley, another great friend of Leigh's. He's going to come up.
Amen.
I'm getting a little dizzy up here with the set list. Papa Miley, ladies and gentlemen.
I can't stay when you're
Baba Molly. Yeah, you're right. Okay, now we're getting back in order. We're going to bring Lenny Zenith back up here. This is another song that we did at the 2016 Jazz Fest with Leigh, with a cast of like 35 musicians. But please welcome Lenny back to the stage.
So, you know, one thing about Leigh is nobody could do a reading of a song quite like Leigh. She took many songs and made them her own. And Jimmy did the arrangement for this, which is great, as he did for some other songs. And I would encourage everybody to sing along. You might know this one.
When you sing along with this one, you might summon demons.
Yeah. Jimmy Robinson, Paul Clement, Mark Whitaker, and Fran Kaminsky.
Lenny Zenith.
Thank you.
So, okay, as we mentioned before, Leigh liked to take a lot of strange sources of material and change them and make them her own. She tried the Zeppelin for a minute, and she didn't quite stick in her tongue that well. She did this song with us once, and at the end, she said, Robert Plant, about his lyrics, she said, well, he's no Ira Gershwin. So, anyway, we do it as an instrumental in her honor.
Thank you.
y'all. Wooden Head and the Bone Around the Horns. Cheers. Checking it, check, check, check. Oh my God, it looks like tips. I like it. It's funny, it's all part of the story. Check, check. Wayne, that's still a little responsible. Could you make it a little irresponsible, please?
All right, so this is a song that I knew Leigh for a number of years before I ever got to really work with her. I think the first time I played with her was sitting in with her and Paxton over here at the Old Point Bar once upon a long time ago. Yeah, I think that's when I met you. And when they still had a piano in there, they had a baby grand, right? Something like that, or they had a piano. All right, whatever. It was made of wood. It wasn't like red and didn't say Nord. But then a few years later, I was doing my radio show and Leigh called in and she said, I'm making a new record and I'm looking for tunes. And so one of the ones I recommended was the flip side for the song that I've always used as my theme song. This is a song by the late, great Alvin Shine Robinson. He had his own version of the tune, Something You Got, that we all know. And so I guess he went up to New York with Joe Jones and the King Curtis Band, and they did an answer song to Something You Got. It goes something like this. This one's for Doris. Well, I made up my mind. Yes, I'm leaving this time. You made it work all day, but it didn't pay. You don't love me no more. Yeah, honey, you gotta go. When you do come Something about Shine, Alvin Shine Robinson. Papa Molly on the slide. So look, now the real kicker to the story is the reason Leigh called in that day was I had gotten turned on to one of the heaviest funk songs I had ever heard, and it was produced by a guy I used to play with called Eddie Bo. Anybody remember Eddie Bo? And I got hooked on this song, and I was found like, who is this woman singing this? And I played it on the air, and Leigh called up. She's like, what the fuck was that? I almost crashed my car. I said, well, that was a song called Reborn by Marilyn Barber. And she said, can you get me a copy of that? Because I got to record that. So when Jimmy, y'all give it up for Jimmy Robinson, by the way, because putting this together is no joke. So in honor of that and to remember Leigh, we are very lucky to have with us the one and only New Orleans legend, Miss Marilyn Barberan. Y'all give it up.
Hey, dude. Like the mic. All right, y'all. We all did a jam with us, huh? Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. I was 15 years old, y'all. And I've been reborn again.
Ah!
Mark Stone, Marilyn Barberin, Papa Molly. So I moved to New Orleans in 1997 after having come down here for Jazz Fest and finding reasons not to stay away for much longer. And I've been here for probably about 3 or 4 days when I met Leigh for the first time. And I knew of her before I met her. But by the time the night was over, it was as if we had known each other forever. And she was family from then on out. Everybody on this stage I met because of her. So many of the things in my life that have happened because of her. And I've been working with Josh for the last almost 25 years because of her. So she has been the conduit that has made so many things possible. And I think if you think for more than a minute or two, you'll find that your experience is probably at least a little bit the same. So we're gonna do a couple songs that Josh and Leigh used to do together and that Josh and I do together now.
Around on my feet. Just trying to find my baby and bring him back home with me. I said, come on with me, baby. You just gotta be convinced. If you don't know I love you, you just
thanks, everybody. You didn't think we were going to get through this without doing a real tearjerker, though, did you? Yeah. If you don't have a drink in your hand, you're going to regret that decision in about 30 seconds. So, a wrist slitter, as Leigh would call it. Josh has a better story about this than I do. I just try to get through it without crying. Sorry. It's an audible here for the sound department. Hang on.
They called me to record this tune with her, and she had this demo recording of it. It was this very esoteric sort of jazz piece, and I was trying to cop it, and I was just sucking. And got into the studio and tried to do it, and it really wasn't happening. And the producer said, after about the third take, the producer said, Josh, what are you doing? I said, well, I'm playing the tune like it was on the demo. He said, oh, no. That's not why we called you here. We called you because we want you to play it like James Booker would have. I went, oh, well, why didn't you say so? And then we nailed it in one take.
Like you do. So this is a song that Leigh recorded on a record that she did called House of Secrets. And it was released, and there were some complications with the release, and it did not get all the attention it should have. As far as I'm concerned, for New Orleans music in the 90s, it's our pet sounds. So if you don't have it, go get it. You'll be better for it, I promise. It's called House of Secrets. Thank you.
But if the subject of romance should arise, then I've gotta go. I can't let my true colors start to show. What else can I do when every dream I've dreamed has come untrue because of you? I'm gonna paint this old town blue. I'm gonna paint.
Somebody else come back up on stage. I don't know what else to do after that. Shoot myself out of a cannon into a brick wall? Jump off the balcony into a glass of water? Like, I'm running out of tricks here. There's Andre. Oh, I don't need anybody else? Yeah, well. It's a nice trick, but you can only do it once. We're going to do another Leigh song that... a song that she wrote. I don't think she gets nearly enough credit for being the songwriter that she was, but she was a brilliant song composer and an incredible wordsmith. If you ever had a conversation with her, you were bringing a knife to a gunfight. I don't care who you were. So we're gonna do a song that she wrote, assuming that other people come up. One more what? Oh, Jesus. Interpretive dance? I'm trying to think of jokes I can tell, but none of them are dirty enough to be worthy of Leigh. Usually I'm trying to keep it clean, but, you know, there's really no hill tall enough to scale for this one. I don't know. I'm not in charge tonight. It's actually been very liberating. So here's a song that seasonally could not be more appropriate. If you're not hot, you're probably dead.
So just lean into it, I guess. That's Ricky Cortez on the bass. I said that's Ricky Cortez on the bass. I can hear you, see?
Too hot to cook up to the mess of
This came into my possession about 5 minutes before I came out here for this last little section. I'll give you one guess who it belonged to. I'm not a queen, but I play one on TV.
Whoa, I like that.
We're gonna do another song that Leigh wrote. I seem to remember there was some sort of prestigious recognition of this song at one point. And she was asked to give a statement, and there was a press release and stuff. And I asked her what happened. She goes, "Oh, I wrote a song and I won a prize."
What a treat. Excuse me.
Yeah, that's all it really was. But what a song. It's called Crazy Mirrors. That's not that one. We're going to do another one. Did Leigh write with this one?
How about I'll sing one and you sing the other one?
Jesus.
What am I doing?
I'm so confused.
Can't get rid of my phone.
Yeah. This is an old percolator song. This is an old percolator song. There was a band called the Percolators for a minute. They were in all the papers.
Bye.
Thanks, y'all. She was a tiny little person, but she had big old feet to fill. Doing my best to keep up with what she wrote. So here's that song that she wrote a song and won a prize. I still don't know what the prize was, but she was proud enough to recognize it, not proud enough to specify. And she has recorded 4 versions of this song that I know of, and they're all different, and they're all amazing.
Playing the same song at the same time. That's what we're gonna do now.
Yeah, we changed that. You got the tickets for the best. A little surprise.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't we straighten that out?
It's a preference. I'll get
you. Blame physics.
Who's counting
this in?
Baby, we could be alone together.
Thanks, everybody. Hey, look, it's Darcy Malone. Oh my God, it's not a Zoom meeting. It's Darcy Malone.
Wait.
Hey, y'all.
Oh, okay.
I probably don't have cooties, but just in case, I have cooties.
That's the shared microphone.
It's not that hard.
With Debbie's special blend of sanitizer.
She cooks up her own.
I used to believe I never know no home. Just keep drifting from door to door. Guess I was lost for years, halfway blinded by tears, and wondering what in the hell I've come here for. Till you said,
come on in, I'm your special friend. You can rest here till your train is due. After a while, we both found our smiles. Ooh, I ain't going nowhere without you.
People can go talk about me, saying how I'll always be crazy through and through. I don't care what people say. They wouldn't know me if they saw me today, baby. I was just practicing before I found you in the sand. Searching like crazy, I didn't know what for. Took one look, I didn't have to look no more. All this time, I was just practicing, always practicing.
Dusty Malone.
That's for Leigh.
Debbie Davis!
Amazing!
Giving it all up. Bonorama
back up here.
I'm one step ahead, which is not helpful in this case, it turns out.
Though usually very helpful.
More often than not. We've got two songs left, is that right? Two songs left, y'all.
Yeah. Oh, all right. Just trying to get in my spot.
Yeah, you're.
Oh, it's so greasy.
little sister gonna cook up a big black roux. Melt down the fat filet from Mr. Saturan. Gonna do something crazy to you. Shuck them up for they shuck you. Cook all day, but it's worth the wait, 'cause we're going straight to gumbo heaven. If you're not, so don't get lazy, Lizzie. Come on, mama. But the life. Oyster, Lizzie, shuck the little oysters for the fucking oyster shuck all over you. Cook all day, but it's worth the wait, 'cause we're going to gumbo heaven. Gumbo, yeah, yeah. Gumbo, yeah, yeah.
Oh, that is very tasty.
Thank you.
and Young, y'all.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Bonorama, Debbie Davis, Darcy Malone, Andre Boren, John Mernier. People too numerous to mention. I'd love to be able to do it, but my attention span is not that.
Lenny Zenith should be coming up here soon.
We're going to get Ricky Cortez back up here, too.
It's worth mentioning, we've got one more song. I'll give you a hint what it is. If you were here early, you already heard it. Yeah, it's not really a spoiler. It's you got to bookend this show with the thing that makes the most sense. And it's worth mentioning that the other co-composer of this song, Ron Cuccia, passed away 3 weeks ago. And I'm certain they're here. I can't imagine any place else the two of them would be.
Where else would they be?
Yeah. So if you got something left in your glass,
barely, but yes.
It's a sacrament. It doesn't count as alcohol. This is religion you're participating in. I'm not wrong. Kiss. And the karate
Thank y'all. Good night.
Jimmy Robinson putting all this together.
Yeah. Yes, indeed.
Hardest working man in the room.
Woo. Oh, my goodness. Thank you so much for the love of Leigh. This has been Leela Palooza.
You coined that.
That's copyright, Allison Young.
Yeah. I'll never make any money this way.
Thank you so much. Good night.